Well, I got some good news for you, and I have some bad news for you. Scratch A. Let's go with B. Just bad news, especially when it comes to the banks, because the insiders, the people with billions and billions and billions and billions of dollars, are all, not all. Well, I mean, for the most part, if they own a bank and it's called Credit Suisse, they are selling their stocks. They actually cue the fire because I forgot a former. That's what happens. Like Fed officials, former, you know, first they buy, then they sell at the top, and then they become former Fed officials. But you have former top Credit Suisse shareholders sell full stake. That's all of it. Well, that's probably great news, right? I mean, what could possibly go wrong? The economy's great. The banking system's great, which I just showed you in yesterday's video. That, I mean, what, Silvergate? Oh, that's it. That's gone. You can't get your money out of the banks. China can't get your money out. We have liquidity. And the Fed's like, yeah, I told you. And not just that, holding cash, which, you know, on this channel, I happen to like that. My wife likes it a little bit more. But holding cash is going to be the winner again in 2023. 2022, 2023. I mean, heck, just stick it into a bond gaining 5%. Easy money. Also, for those of you that are like, oh, you know, the market's good, everything's great, January was great. January economy looked too good to be true. It probably was. You always have those bounces on the way down. So make sure you take advantage of the bounces. But coming in from our lead story today, Credit Suisse. Credit Suisse. That's what it looks like right there. Lots of money in there. Well, lots of money was in there. And their banner, their header. Why do you do that, Reuters? Just leave it static. It doesn't have to cover everything. Former top Credit Suisse shareholder sells full stake in bank. And guys, let me help you with this. If, let's say, Elon Musk sells his stake in Tesla at the top, okay? That's a good thing for Elon, bad thing for you. So always follow what the leaders are doing. Do as they do, not as they say. And actually, they lost one of their biggest backers, right? Ah, well, that's okay, because you get to take that money and get to buy whatever you want. You want a yacht? You want two yachts, private jet, big houses, all the things that really don't matter, won't make you happy. You're still a miserable person in the yacht, in big houses, but that's okay. You do psychopath. Not saying that he is. I'm just saying. I've met quite a few in my life. Credit Suisse loses one of the biggest backers. Hero says Harris Associates sold out over the past month. And I say that's okay because you probably would have also because you are following the charts. And the charts will always predict these news stories. The charts will always predict what these guys are going to do. Also, if you are interested in learning how to do what you could beat the insiders. I mean, actually, you want to know what that yellow line is? I know what it is. That it was a negative divergence. That's, you can actually find negative divergences in my swing trading course and my bear market course. I put them both in there for you because it's actually important. Because I knew that at some point when this, because this was going up and this was staying flat and going down, it's going to reverse, which it did. It went right into my hair, and it got completely lost. But actually, you would know on this one, that 200-day moving average that is above my head that I said in a previous video, Paul Tudor Jones uses that, and he's worth, what, $7.5 billion? More billions than I will ever have. Yeah. I'm gonna swing for the fences on this one and say I will never have $7.5 billion. I know I'm selling myself short, but to get there, you need to understand how this works. That's that blue line. Don't trade under that blue line. Well, I mean, you can, but you got to get in, get out. I like to call it like a shark tank. You put your little feet in the water, and you're like, here they come. You got to get out. No, like buy and hodl. But here is Credit Suisse all the way down. Keep on a going. And to me, this isn't the time to sell. You know, you want to know what the time to sell is? Hold on. You want to go up, you want to go up here, right? When you're above the, right here. That's the money. That right up there. That would have been about $12. right when you cross below the 200-day moving average. And if you are interested in learning how to trade above it or below it, if you want to trade above it, that's my bull market course, swing trade, very simple. What am I giving? 60% off because it's a month that I'm guessing we're in March. Take my March special. So 60% off or my bear market course, same thing. All the courses, 60% off, or you can just do my, $199, which beats everything, but that means you have to have everything, and that's four payments of $199. You get everything that I've ever taught. And that was from high school to college. Yep, college professor, all those kind of goodies. And some people are like, oh my gosh, you're selling a course. Well, yeah, I'm a professor. Remember all those college classes that you took that didn't add up to anything except for a sheet of paper and could learn things like this and make $7.5 billion. But this is, not financial advice. That would just be paper trading. I know. It is what it is. But there's just some key principles that you need to understand in life. So either I'll teach it to you or life will teach it to you. Whichever one you want. Or you could just keep holding the bags for everyone. But another key principle. A Fed study shows loose monetary policy leads to disaster and financial crisis. Thank you, Mishtalk. And you showed us some very nice graphs. That would be correct. And that's what the Fed does. And the Fed's now in trouble. And now they're insolvent in their balance sheet. I showed you that in another video. Yeah, was it yesterday? It's all not good looking for the banks. And Janet needs to be paid. So you gotta pay the piper. And you go loose, tight, and in the tightening, everything gets wrecked. In the expansion, everything is great. It is called boom bust cycles. We are at the top of a boom, rolling over into a bust, and I am warning you, it's bust a move time. Actually, talking about bust a move, the banks are finally, even though I had them beat a year ago, 5% on the day. Well, it's on the yearly. That's what I get. Easy money, 5%. 1 year. I think a 6 month is right around 5% also. So I am moving my money from a savings account or a checking account or whatever you guys have. This would be like at Chase or I don't know what bank you bank at. But I'm like, oh, here we go. We're moving the. I move the money before they can move the money. And they play like arbitrage. That's what banks do. And they make money. Because some people are too stupid and they leave all their money in cash. And whenever you put your money into the bank, they do one of three things. They loan it, which for some reason, people aren't doing those loans right now. They buy mortgage-backed securities or bonds. So which one is it? Well, that's up to them. They make the money, you don't. But finally, U.S. banks are finally, I said that word twice, being forced to raise on deposits. Deposits declined last year for the first time since 1948. Because people listen to Johnny Bravo. Johnny Bravo's like, hey, you should pick up the phone call and move your money, which that's just a simple thing. I think even CDs, what are they, 3.5? I mean, again, it's the arbitrage. But if you do a six-month or a five-month bond, it's a 5%. That's really good. So people are doing it. You should probably do it. And then also learn how to swing it. You swing it. You roll it. It goes down, you buy it. It goes up, you sell it. I know. Easier said than done, but then you have all these indicators that show you when to do it, and then you don't look like a complete idiot like I used to, listening to, fundamentals, and, they're going to do this, and Elon's going to do that. That never worked for me, and it was so difficult teaching that in university and high school. They're like, Mr. Bravo, what you're saying isn't coming true, and I'm like, I gotta figure this one out. Although I will say I did leave a lot in S&P 500, okay? So I never touched that one. That one is just left for a rainy day. But at the end of the day, just please understand, guys, they're digits. That's all they are. And they're debt digits. Fugazi, fugazi. It doesn't make you any more happier if you have stuff, you don't have stuff. Digits do fix problems. So if you got some problems, money solves it. Or you could be Vanilla Ice, because Vanilla Ice solves problems. So if you're not Vanilla Ice, then make sure you have money, because then money solves it. But anyways, holding cash, I said at the beginning, will be a winning strategy. And you need winning strategies in 2023. This is what investors say. Well, you're an investor, so why would you even know? But yes, anyways, that's what we just do. We go equities, or we go bonds, and then we go cash. Then we go equities, and then we go cash. And if you just want to total cash, over the long period, you're probably not going to like your portfolio, but it looks like passive funds and ETFs are doing, oh, did you guys catch that Jim Cramer ETF, the inverse Cramer ETF? So you can actually, anything he says, they just short. So it's actually up because Cramer's down. And actually the ticker symbol is SJIM, short Jim. It started at the top, way up there. Now it's way down here. So I guess, again, I mean, you need a little bit more data for me to trade something like this. But hey, if you guys want to catch a falling knife on Jimmy, have at it. What Jimmy would do is say, I don't believe in these chart patterns, right? I've heard him say that more than once. So I know he does not believe in technical analysis. Well, you're probably not going to make any money if you don't understand technical analysis. That's why I passionately jump up and down and say, please learn it. If you're watching this channel and you've subscribed, or if you've subscribed and you look down, you're like, oh, YouTube just unsubscribed me. That's weird. That's because they hate me. So go ahead and click the button again so I can do everything in my power to teach you technical analysis. So then you can use that to your advantage so you can make your digits go in the correct direction. Not this. So holding cash will be the strategy for 2022, 2023. Selling your house, back when I did, when I went to cash, would be a winning strategy. And now on to the, how's the housing market doing? Well, I'm glad you asked. And he does not look very happy about it. He's going to start talking. And
all right,
it's all right. We got this. Housing affordability at a record low, a report said. Number of affordable listings fell 53% from a year earlier. So you can't have things that are very expensive because then, you know, people won't buy them. That's usually the solution. High prices usually solve themselves. But it is okay. All of my six daughters who are like, Dad, when can I buy a house? Well, it's not yet. You're getting there. But Dave Ramsey said, I know, it's 8 months ago. He said, now is the perfect time to buy. Dave was wrong. But that's okay because I've been wrong in my life. I think it's a time to wait. And the good news is, Austin's just getting, that place, getting pummeled. Housing market momentum stalls as critical spring season approaches, raising interest rates, blah, blah, blah. All of this, prices, it's just a perfect setup for a perfect collapse. I do know a lot of builders, and everyone's kind of scared. Actually, they're not doing anything because they know they don't want to lose their capital. There's a lot of capital that goes into building these things like this. Like we're talking millions, right? You want a vacant lot for 1.57 million per acre, 2.85 for the apartment building. It's expensive. And for me, I would just rather click a button and go, okay, I'll take my 1.7 million because there's a lot that goes into real estate. Or especially not just real estate, but commercial real estate and building and permits and blah and that. And when you want to finally exit, you're like, oh, looks like I got in at the wrong time. That is why I like trading. And you could trade the housing market just on the computer, right? There's ticker symbols. I don't know. Thanks to Stephen Van Meter pointing that one out to me when I'm like, okay, time to collect real estate, right? You wait for a crash. I do it, Kiyosaki. I just screwed his name up. My apologies. Dad, poor dad, Kiyosaki. Sorry, Robert. I mean, that was always my, okay, I'm going to buy lots of real estate. I mean, actually got out in 08. That was that. Even my rental, Texas, California, everything. It's just so much easier to click a button. Take advantage of learning how to click buttons and make your life a little bit easier. And I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow because I work every single day of my life just for you.